Hey friends, today I am hanging out at the Grand Floridian. The Christmas tree here actually came up last night, so I immediately had to rush over here. I went to the Wilderness Lodge and checked out their tree already. So this is both of my favorite resorts during the holidays have their Christmas trees up. I'm so excited. Let's go do this. They have some beautiful lights and garland in the porte-cochere. I absolutely love it here. It's so elegant, and even the Christmas decorations is elegant. Can you hear the Christmas music? We didn't even make it in yet. Oh, I am so excited. You can see the lights reflecting. Oh wow, it's a beauty, guys. You got these two smaller trees right here, and then the main attraction right in the middle of the lobby. I love it so much. This is the small tree out front, then you got the big one in the middle, and then another one right over here on this side. So elegant. I'm also gonna stop into Basin and see if they have any holiday soaps available, and maybe look at some merchandise, because you never know what you're gonna find here. They even have another little baby tree right here next to the elevator. Look at how it's like lined up perfectly with the big tree right in the middle. That's cool. I also believe that the ornaments at the Grand Floridian Christmas tree are like the most beautiful and probably the most mixed, like when it comes to a different variety. We have the 12 days of Christmas ornaments. We've got the bird cages, a lot of classic Christmas ornaments, and even, stop looking at me, swan. And on top of that, I see a little hidden Mickey here too. I don't know if it's technically a hidden Mickey. Oh wait, it is a hidden Mickey because those are two separate ornaments. Yeah, this isn't a Mickey ornament. Those are two separate. Wow, that's really cool, a hidden Mickey. But boy, oh boy, like I said, this is probably the best you're gonna get. On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two turtle doves and a partridge in a pear tree. I can go all day, but I think I'll save you guys. 5 golden rings. I also noticed that they have two more trees on the second level, and then take a look at all the garland going all the way around the club level here. It is beautiful. And you can also appreciate the tree from like the different levels in here. We can't get up to those top three levels, but we can go up to the one. And normally I would take the elevator, but that staircase over there is so beautiful. I always love this stairway at the Grand Floridian. It's my favorite stairway of Walt Disney World, but add a little Christmas to it and I just love it even more. Look at that. I always feel like I'm somebody important when I'm walking up and down these steps. If you've ever been lucky enough to see Cinderella or Prince Charming actually coming down these steps, that's what I mean. Like, I feel like I'm somebody important. But there it is. Can you hear the music even? You normally can't hear the music down the lobby right now because it's like very busy down there, but if you like tuck to the side here, you can hear it a little bit better. I tremendously will miss the Grand Floridian Orchestra here this year, but don't worry, in a couple of days, a future vlog possibly, we're gonna be seeing the Grand Floridian Orchestra. That makes me so happy. But isn't it just a sight for sore eyes? I'm so happy to see the Christmas trees and the garland and everything like that. Like normally, I get excited about the holidays, but this year is a lot more different. Like, we need Christmas more now than ever, I feel like. And since we're on the second floor, we'll hit up the mercantile, look at all the holiday displays, and then bounce over to Basin and see if they have any holiday soap. Look at Mickey in the window here. I like that little milk thing down there. Ice cold milk for Santa. That's really cool. I bet you that's for the gingerbread set. But wow, it's so festive in here too, isn't it? I love it. They've got their own special decorations just for the mercantile in here. And you know what? I think I'm gonna buy this Santa hat. Sold. Oh, I love it. I absolutely love it. This can't be my wintertime hat because it's way too hot. There's no way I'd be able to wear this in the parks. But when I visit the resorts and stuff like that, I'm all about it. So now let's take a look inside Basin White and maybe they got some holiday soaps. And of course we're gonna wash our hands. And here's all the holiday soaps. You know what's funny? I didn't even break out my Halloween yet. But I think I'm gonna have to pick one up. I don't know which one I should go with, the mistletoe or this one. Oh, that's tough. I think I might just stick with the ho 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 one. Yeah. Wait, oh, it tells me the different flavors. Hold on. So this one's like a forest cedar. This one is cinnamon. This one is an icy blend of citrus. This one is a sugar plum. And this one is refreshing mint. Maybe this one, that's the one. Now that we discovered they're actually selling holiday soaps at Basin, maybe we'll go down to the different gift shops and see if any chance they might have a gingerbread shingle for sale. Like I know that they sell them sometimes, and since they're not doing the gingerbread houses, it'd be good if you can just at least buy one. Wait a second, that wasn't a swan, that was a geese. And take a look at this little geese wreath, and it's not even a little one. That's like actually a very big wreath. My mom likes making wreaths. Oh, and I'm with my friend.
Hi.
And she has a channel, Life with Presley.
Life with Presley, check it out.
Yeah. Normally, they used to sell the gingerbread, like the shingles inside Sandy Cove. So we're just gonna take a peek-see. Maybe they're here. Unfortunately, they're not gonna be selling the shingles in Sandy Cove, but they did say if they do end up selling them, it's gonna be over at Gasparilla's. So that's good to know. There's hope. There is hope. And speaking of Gasparilla's, they actually aren't doing any holiday things right now. Well, they're doing Thanksgiving holiday stuff. They have a cinnamon apple almond tart, a pumpkin pie cake pie, and a maple leaf cookie sandwich. I'll duck into the Enchanted Rose just to see if they're actually gonna be doing any holiday drinks, but I highly doubt it, only because they keep to the theming inside there. But you never know, I can see like a beast, wintery, like mixed cocktail. That would be really cool. Oh, now this is fun. Look at, we're riding the elevator. We're getting like a full scan of the tree. Actually, at the actual Enchanted Rose, they're doing their seasonal old fashions, and this is kind of like a holiday old fashioned with a little cranberry twist. So I'm excited to try that, but other than that, there are no special holiday drinks. Here it is, the seasonal old fashioned. It's a cranberry with Widow Jane, some brown sugar. They don't actually tell you what it is. It just tells you seasonal old fashioned on the menu, but I'm excited to try it. This is actually Presley's first old fashioned. So you got a fancy one to try.
I'm excited.
Cheers.
Cheers.
All right, I'll go ahead. It is a very good old fashioned. It is $25 though, so you kind of have to put that in a price point comparison. It's like a very good drink, so you're gonna enjoy it. You know what I mean? For $25, that's what you're getting. At the end, it got super, super delicious. And I think it was because you had all of that like kind of like orange peel and cranberries just resting at the bottom, but the last couple sips, that's where it was at. And I'm gonna take this ice cube home and take it home with me. Put it in your purse. But now I think we're gonna move along. Yeah, Enchanted Rose was delicious. The seasonal old-fashioned is a good touch. I wish I came here and tried that for maybe Halloween. If they had a pumpkin old-fashioned that I missed, I'm a little disappointed. And we're gonna take the stairs so we can enjoy all the beautifulness. Man, I just love it. Isn't it? Like, don't you feel important walking down these steps?
That's what I said.
Like, you just feel like you belong. Yes, the queen. Oh, look at that. Oh, I like that. You're doing a great job. Hello. Normally, this place would be so busy and the gingerbread house would be in the center and there'd be a line of people trying to get their shingles. It definitely seems different, but like, I feel like Christmas trees are like a symbol of hope. Like, honestly, that's really sad because I've always appreciated Christmas, like I said, but we definitely need Christmas more this year than we probably ever had. And that means a lot that we're actually getting some of it. Even if it's not the whole shabam, it's just good to be able to sit back, relax, and enjoy the tree. Listen to the music. This is good stuff. Another really good thing about the lobby at the Grand Floridian is the mixture of different seating places. So like, you can have these fancy chairs right here, or you can actually sit down on a nice little couch. Look at this couch. This is really classy stuff here, folks. And with that, friends, I think we are done here today. I had so much fun. We've now gotten the Wilderness Lodge done and the Grand Floridian. So all we have to do is really check out Animal Kingdom Lodge when they put up their tree and the Grandestino. And we basically covered all of our favorite holiday resorts. Anywho's, I hope you enjoyed the video. I enjoyed making it. We'll see you next time. Bye. But as I was leaving the Grand Floridian, look at the decorations for the shades of green. This is amazing, guys. I'm gonna give you, oh, you can see the lights from Magic Kingdom over there. Yeah, over here, watch. You'll see all of the cadets once we get down here a little bit. Isn't that pretty, guys? I absolutely love it.